In the last episode, we set up Webpack at PWA and Workbox, and this allowed us to make an app where all the requests would be served via a service worker. So if you were to turn off Rails, it would still like work, which is quite cool. However, the code is a little bit basic, so we're going to go through and expand upon that today and play around with some different strategies. I've added two new packages since I last recorded an episode, Workbox Cacheable Response and Workbox Expiration. So if I go into App, JavaScript, Service Workers, and the Service Worker file, you can see I'm using them a little bit there. I haven't implemented them yet, but they give us some additional functionality, which is going to be really useful. We're going to fix the first problem with our current approach of just kind of caching everything, conserving that cache file. And that's if I go to the post index and change the post, like the title here, it doesn't update. And that's not very good. So we need to fix that. So what we're going to do is we're going to make it so our requests, if it's a document of some form, we're going to try the network first and then fall back to the cache. But if it's an asset, we are going to always use the cache first method. The first thing I'm going to do is show you a little trick to see what this request object looks like, because it just makes it so much easier to kind of debug this this kind of setup we've got here. And what we're going to do is we're going to console.log that request and just go false. So this will output this somewhere and we can have a good look at it. So that's pretty cool. So I'm going to quickly unregister that worker, and we can see it can't connect because I need to turn on Rails. There we go. We're going to go to About Debugging to have a look at all the service workers we've got. So we've got a few here, it's going to unregister that one. This is the one we've set up for our little app here. I'm going to click inspect, and right now there's nothing, but if I was to refresh this page, we can see we've got some request objects here, which look like what we want to be looking at. So what we can see, if we open this CSS file, says, okay, we have an object that looks a bit like this. So you know, its destination is style, credentials include, there's no cause. Okay, let's have a look at the image. Okay, I have destination image there, that's quite interesting. And we have destination script for our JavaScript files. So if it requests a JavaScript file, it says, okay, I'm looking for a JavaScript file, that's quite cool. And for the actual HTTP method, where it's saying we're loading the page even, looks like we've got mode navigate and destination document. Okay, so we could potentially hook into these destination methods. I guess they'll be methods. And kind of maybe split up our cache a bit. So let's open up our file, push that to the side. What we're going to do is, I think we'll keep in one of these just at the very top so we can always see all the requests. We'll add a little line here, and we're like, request destination equals document, and we'll store it in a cache called documents, and we're going to make that a network first connection. And so a little comment there, network loading pages network first. For assets, we check the cache first. Cool. We're going to copy that out. And we're just going to whack it in here where we say, okay, if it's script, or maybe it is a style, we're going to say, sure, we're going to call these like mid-length assets. Let's call it assets styles and scripts. And lastly, we're going to create one where we cache the images somewhere else as well. So my thought being that our images, we might end up storing a lot of them, and we don't want to store lots and lots of images. Potentially, we might only want to store like a few, so we might want to limit the amount we store. We might want to come up with different rules around them, so because we are only limited to about 25 megs of storage. So, okay, cool. So this is gonna, see what this does. Let's have a look at this. So we're gonna unregister that service worker. Load this up. Looks like it's doing its thing. Okay. So you can see that all the requests are going through the service worker. That's updated to be 1, 2, 3, 4. And if I was to change that again, that's pretty cool. So the title there is changing to what I actually see in my HTML, which is quite nice. Yeah. And if I was to turn off Rails now, sweet, that's still loads. It will fall back to the cache version. That's pretty nice. And let's actually have a look at how these are stored. So I think they're stored in static resources. Have a little look ski. Sometimes I find you've got to reload this inspector quite a few times to actually see the changes kick in. But okay, so we can see the documents there. All the styles and scripts are there, and we've got the fav icon there, and then we have the old static resources, which we can probably delete now. Okay, that's pretty nice. That's kind of what we want. And if we were to have a quick look at our service worker again, see what it's up to. Okay, that's pretty nice. I like that. So one interesting thing you're going to notice is if you click show, in this case, what we can see here is it said like no root has been found. When we look more closely, it says we've just made a cause request. And this is because under the hood, I am actually using TurboLinks. And we can see it kind of has a little header right here saying TurboLinks referrer. So this means that we're not actually caching requests made via TurboLinks. So it'd be really nice to solve that. So again, we can kind of see right here, we have a few kind of telltale signs that this is a TurboLinks request. So we're gonna do the same as we've done here. We're gonna register a network first, kind of root. We're gonna say TurboLinks, check the network first. We're going to quickly move this all to one line. You can see the destination is always going to be blank, which is fine. And the mode is going to be cause. So mode equals cause. That's cool. I'm going to do add. And the last thing we're also going to check is we can see we can access the headers here. And we know there is a TurboLinks referrer header being sent with the request. So what we're going to do is say request.headers.get this one and should not equal null. So that should be enough to say, hey, if this is TurboLinks, let's cache it somewhere. And let's also say dash TurboLinks just to really split out those caches a little bit better. Cool. Alrighty, I'm going to register our service worker again. Cool, that's going places. See what we've got here. So far to say show. Okay, should be there, okay. Click edit this time. Ooh, there we go. So, just to kind of show you what's happened here. I'm going to clear this output. If I click edit, it's made the one TurboLinks request here, and it said, hey, we actually have that, and we're going to respond with it, which is super nice. And if you go to our storage, you can see we've got the TurboLinks pages in there as well. So that's quite nice. One thing we haven't touched on yet is the stay a while, revalidate approach to the service worker caching. So what this will do is it will use the cache version of the page first and then make a HTTP request behind the scenes to update the file it's serving. It's a lot easier to explain like visually, so we're going to do that. So I've just updated the service worker. We're going to refresh the page. We've got a nice new one going. And it's probably got this page all cached up now, so that's great. I'm going to change this to be 1234, so this bit here. You can see that time it returned its cache. And the second time, it's going to return that change file. So for us to change that back, we get the cache file, and then we get the updated one. So this is quite cool if maybe you want to have a really, really fast response time on something, and you're okay for someone to have slightly out of date information. Personally, I do prefer Lights Network first, but that's just me. We also have these cacheable response plugin and exploration plugins. So on all of these, you can add like additional plugins to change how they respond. I pulled these out of the docs here. And we're going to quickly go through kind of what they've got, because it saves me a lot of typing. So, with this one here, so for our documents, we're going to say if anything is older than 5 minutes, then just delete it, and we only want to save stuff where it's got a status of 0 or 200. So that's quite cool. For the sake of the demo, we're going to pull that way down to like 5 entries. And we're going to do the same on all of these. So the idea of these plugins is you only have about 25 megabytes to safely play with service workers. So you want to be really strict with how much you kind of actually store. And I think for like images, we can store them for up to 30 days. Same with scripts. Okay, that should be all right. Let's give that a quick go and see what that does. Okay, fantastic. We have something going on here. Let's have a little inspect here. So what we can see is when it's using the cache first approach, it also has a thing saying, hey, I've run the exploration and found nothing I need to remove. So that's quite good. And if we go to storage, we can kind of see it's sort of some stuff. When I was like playing around with this before the tutorial, I found it was like kind of working, but kind of not. It could have just been because I'm using it on my local host. But I think it's a good habit to add these in anyway.